Out of the box, the tension was perfect for the Shure SM7B microphone. I do wish it was a little taller and just a bit longer so I can place it at the back of the desk behind my iMac. As you can see in my video, the arm went where I wanted it to go and I don't think it transmitted any more sound than my Rode SAR1 did. If you want to go for a higher quality microphone arm, you can search for the Yellow Technica series. It does come in different sizes, but for 3x the price I would say that the Rode SAR1 is a little easier to use out of the box since there are no tension knobs to adjust compared to this Blue Compass. But the Rode SAR1 looks like every other cheap scissor arm unfortunately. I'll keep it to use as an iPhone camera mount so I don't have to hold it like I did in the video. I bought a Blue Yeti mic a few months ago and found it to be extremely powerful. If you use a Blue Yeti to record gameplay, you're in for a big surprise. It will pick up every sound, including banging on the keyboard and moving the mouse. It's basically impossible to use it on your desk if you want quality recordings. This boom arm is perfect, and it's highly advisable to pair it with a shock mount, made by the same company, to achieve optimal results. I play a lot of shooters and the banging sounds went away after I purchased these items. This is the best looking boom you can buy for under or around $100. Let's address why people are leaving negative reviews. 1. The internal spring is very strong, but that's good because it's designed to hold heavy microphones. This is a good thing. 2. The videos you see of other people's booms falling is because they aren't strong enough to turn the locking mechanism fully because the spring is strong. So find someone who is strong that can properly tighten the joints. 3. Easily the best for the money. Better looking than the Rode. Fits any kind of mic. 4. My mic is super heavy and it holds it like a champ.